Okay, Graeme, we've got questions from fans of the official England cricket Facebook site, TwelfthMan. We'll start with one from Sam Morgan. Sam says, where did your passion for cricket start and how did you get to the highest level of the sport?
My passion started from the fact that my dad played and then my big brother played, and so I obviously wanted to do whatever my dad and big brother did. They play cricket. I don't often wish that they were Premiership footballers or, you know, world's best golfers, because I'd hate to think that I was just earning millions and millions of pounds a year to play the game.
Absolutely right. Honourable. Chris Sobolowski, I think that's right, has said, how would you set your field bowling to God? And he's a left-handed batsman.
To God?
Yeah, apparently God's a left-hander as well.
God would be a left-hander. I'd probably put two in case one just bounced and gripped a bit. But the thing is, being all omnipotent, he knows what I'm going to bowl anyway. So I'd probably just put all men out and throw it up a bit, see if he'd take me on. I'd get him in the end.
Ian Sanderson says, favourite Oasis song?
That's a tricky one because there's so many good ones. Probably go back to Some Might Say. It's the first song I always play whenever I get a new car. I always put Some Might Say on. I don't know why, it's a stupid superstition, but hell of a song.
Rob Nibbs, you broke into the England team and achieved the success you were having quite late in your career. You think you would have done as well if you were given your chance in your early 20s, or given more of a chance?
I seriously think had I played when I was 19, 20, I'd have broken Morley's record by now.
Absolutely right. There you go, Rob. Hugh Anderson says, what is the best publishable exchange of banter you've had on a cricket pitch?
Well, by the very nature that it'd be publishable, it'd be rubbish, because all the funny stuff is obviously riddled with swear words and innuendo. So I can't really say. There was a funny one between Stuart Broad and Mitchell Johnson in the Ashes, but I definitely can't say that out loud. Sorry, I think I'm going to be a bit of a letdown there. I can't say anything.
Swanny. Kelly Louise Hoggins asks, if you could have any other player, on the team's hair, whose would it be? So a haircut from any other player.
I think it's a no-brainer. It'd have to be Stuart Broad. I mean, he's, especially when it was long and flowing and blonde. Oh, beautiful boy. Beautiful.
Nick Salt asks, would you give up playing cricket to be a professional musician?
Well, it depends. You know, if we were breaking America and, you know, already had the commercial stuff in Japan going, then I think about it. As it is, it's quite. I'm quite happy with the way it's going at the minute. I play cricket and I'm also the head of a massive band. Who's still cool enough that no one's heard of them? Which is the best way.
No Nebworth yet. Stephanie Butler says, I'm an off-spin bowler too. What is your best piece of advice for bowling a more consistent line and length? Because she needs lots of help, apparently.
Unfortunately, it's a very boring answer. Sorry, Stephanie. The only way to get more consistent is to practice and just bowl and bowl and bowl. But if you do bowl spin, especially off spin, you've got to be strong up there, because you'll get hit for six and fours, especially when you're young and you're growing up. You've just got to ignore it and pretend it didn't happen. That's what I do. You get to a point where someone hits you for six, and 2 minutes later, if someone asks you, you say, no, I didn't. So, yeah, just lie to yourself. It's the way forward. Lying's okay if it's to yourself.
Denial. Tom Reed says, if you could pick any non-cricketing English sportsman to play cricket for England, who would it be and why?
Interesting question. I'd probably go for Peter Crouch, actually. I said he should have played in goal in the World Cup because of his reach. He couldn't have done any worse. And I'd get Crouch in, I'd stick him at sort of a second, two and a half slip, and he could just take up the whole court, and so he could have nine fielders anywhere else.
Perfect. Iniam Subramoni, I hope I've said that right. What has been the most challenging experience so far in your career?
The most challenging thing is just touring. It's never been at home. Even when we're in England, people think we're at home all the time, but you're only at home for 1 week in every six or seven. So it's that's the most challenging thing. You never see your missus, which can be a good thing, don't get me wrong. But yeah, it can be hard.
And finally, Hayley Newland says, if you could nominate one member of the current England Test squad to be on Extreme Makeover, who would it be? And you can, I guess, include yourself in this.
I think it'd have to be KP, because seeing the way he dresses is just... Well, it's out there. I'll give him that. But I seriously think he needs Gokwan to have a look at him. Maybe a nice pair of chinos and some boat shoes. I think it'd suit Kev, with a cricket jumper tied around his neck. Ralph Lauren style. Yeah, we've got a lot of fashion disasters in our team. The painful thing is they think that they're really cool and dress well. Strauss as well could probably go. because he...
You could go on and on, really. Just nominating the whole team for extreme logo.
There's only two of us who dress really cool. I'm obviously lead singer in a rock band, so... And Jimmy Anderson is a good-looking lad. Sponsored by All Saints, he should be. It's the only place he buys his gear, but he looks all right.
Brilliant, thanks, Swann.
I think my golden question has to be the one about God.
So that was, the golden question is from Chris Sobolowski. How do you set your field bowling to God?
Because he's a left-hander. I just love the fact that he's made God a left-hander. So it'd give me half a chance of getting him out.
So well done, Chris. Golden question.
Well done, Chris.